Seven Steps is, sounds very disparate. You know, it's basically a kind of unedited life study of music, be it show business, nightclub review, musicals, jazz bands, and my card-carrying atonal background, you know, as a student of Kirchner, an assistant to Boulez and all that. You know, so it's all there. I'm sitting there saying, will this all work together? And what Richard Foreman brings to a piece is a spine. Basically, if you fillet that fish, you see beautiful bones. Wasn't really thinking about what the response was, but it was hysterical, honestly. You know? And I think part of it was the newness. Now, again, you're talking about this was not the next John Adams piece, the next Philip Glass piece. There was nothing like it, except in the 20s. I remember when I met Lenya and asked her about the Baden, the various festivals that Kurt Weill and Brecht would do pieces, or Mio or Hindemith. She said, oh, well, when we did the Kleine Mahagoni, we were surrounded by severe atonal pieces. And when we went on and did our little Alabama song, everybody said, oh, a tune! So I think it was a little bit of that, too, with the Elephants, because it did have, you know, showstoppers in the middle of this sort of atonal opera. So there it was in this severe atmosphere of serious art music. And it was this one piece that must have appeared like Hello Dolly in the context of that contemporary music festival. We recorded it at that time. CBS and Columbia had joint, you know, 52nd Street, 30th Street. We recorded in those studios. We had like a super professional cast and musicians and performers. And we were used to working with these young, you know, speculum musici in New York or Tanglewood students. So it was very high professional, the recording.